It is semi-final Saturday here at the 2018 Men's World Floorball Championships as the Czech Republic, the host nation, take on the defending champions Finland in what is set to be an absolutely extraordinary contest. This is how we've got to these teams knocking on the door of the gold medal contest. The Czech Republic defeating Denmark 10-1. Finland defeating Germany 6-1. But all of that now in the past as we look towards this massive game. Eero Kossonen returns in goal for the defending world champions after Lassi Todisaeva did a superb job in the quarterfinal win over Germany. Number 77, Sami Johansson, scored 2 goals in Finland's semi-final win over the Czech Republic in 2016. Jani Kukkola has played in all of Finland's 3 World Championship victories. Will he help them to a 10th final here today? 24-year-old Petter Kotilainen has looked great at the key times, scoring in the Germany game and also the victory over Sweden. Lukasz Socek is going to be a busy custodian for the host nation today. The Czechs will need him on top form. The captain, Matej Jędrzejczak, has 5 goals so far in the tournament, including a hat-trick against Denmark in the quarter-final. Adam DeLong has been a revelation in this competition. He's the Czechs' top scorer on 8 goals. And watch for number 31, Josef Ripar, in the third line. The 25-year-old is in his first World Championships, and he has settled well. It's a repeat of the 2016, 2014, 2010 and 2008 semi-finals. The last one in 2016, Finland won 4-3. It's the 5th time they've met in the semi-finals. Finland have won all of them, but the crucial thing here is this is in the Czechs' back garden. Feel the roar from the Czechs' 5th line, the crowd here in the O2 Arena, who will be always on the field of play, roaring them on as they try to get to only their 2nd ever World Championship final, having reached that point in 2004. What of today? It's the Czech Republic versus Finland in the semi-final, and it's happening now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for national anthems of Finland and Czech Republic.
Kuin kotimaata pohjoinen,
It's filled up rather nicely here in the O2 Arena. There is an absolutely fantastic atmosphere as Matej Jędrzejczak and Niko Salo exchange pennants, exchange handshakes, and there the friendship ends for the next little while, because this is going to be fiercely competitive. Petr Inaki, the head coach of the Finnish team, an enormously experienced coach, and he looks very sanguine and calm about the whole affair. Petri Kettunen, also a Finnish international, but this time coaching the Czech team. He did actually play in the first ever World Championship meeting between the Czech Republic and Finland. He scored against the Czech Republic in 1996, but we won't say that too loudly right now. The team that's won 3 out of 5 World Championships since that historic victory in 2008. But this is going to be a massive, massive test for Finland, because the local fans are ready to cheer every single challenge, to cheer every single shot. It won't put off Juha Kivileto though. The 36-year-old is an absolute veteran. He's been in all 3 of the gold medal winning teams, including in Prague in 2008. Tom Ondrushek is in his 3rd World Championship. He took part in the bronze medal winning team in 2014. And now the lineup: Eero Kossonen, the starting goalkeeper. Jana Laminen wears 17. 2 32-year-olds there, joined by the 24-year-old Krista Savonen. And another 24-year-old in the form of Niko Salo, the captain. Emily Salin, the number 9, who scored the winning goal against the Czech Republic in 2016 with 7 seconds left on the clock. And talking of 7, the number 77, Sami Johansson, who also scored 2 goals in that game, including the opener. Lukáš Souček, the starting goalkeeper for the Czech Republic. The 28-year-old has been in the national team for about 6 years now. Ondřej Němeček is a much newer figure to the national team, but his composure, his calmness at the back will be an asset today. Martin Kutagita plays in Switzerland, is in his 1st World Championship, but has settled well. The captain, Matej Jędrzejczak, who also plays in Sweden, in his 5th World Championships. And Daniel Shebek, the number 3, joined by Yuri Karni, wearing number 40, who plays just northeast of Prague for Floorball Mladá Boleslav. Thomas Anderson, one of 2 Swedish referees, joined by Rickard Wissman. Very experienced officials, the kind of people that you want marshalling over a World Championship contest. And a semi-final to boot, because this one is all or nothing. It's a place in the gold medal contest that awaits the winning side. He's done his work, now the players have to do theirs. And they will do their part on the sidelines, the Prague crowd. But now it's down to the field of play. Now it's down to the players. It's in their hands. Somebody goes for gold. Who will it be? We are underway as Finland, the defending champions in the white and blue, attack the goal to your left. Olli Hogben here in the O2 Arena in Prague, and I'm joined by somebody who's experienced these kind of big games before. Zana Klabere, Latvian international, played in 5 World Championships. You know what this feels like to play in a big semi-final.
Yes. Hi again, everyone. Yes, I know how it is. It's extremely stressful in the beginning, but since the first whistle has gone and the first changes has gone, then everything calms down, at least for the players.
What's interesting is, I think you were feeling vicariously the stress that they were feeling on the field of play beforehand. I could see that you know what they're going through.
Yes. The stakes are so high in these kind of matches.
Finland haven't conceded many goals so far in the competition. Victory over the Swedish team, defeat to the Swedish team, excuse me. Apologies, Swedish fans. A victory over Denmark, a victory over Norway, and then a victory over Germany in the quarter-final. As for the Czech Republic, an impressive 10-5 win over Germany, followed by a defeat 4-3 to Latvia, another impressive 6-4 win over Switzerland, and then advancing past Denmark in the quarterfinals. Patrick Doja, 66, has possession. And surely here, the order of business for the home team is if the Czech Republic can get a really early goal, then that's going to create an absolute pressure cooker in here.
Yes. Early goals always helps. It's very important.
If you were watching the quarterfinals yesterday, you will have seen that Sweden scored after 23 seconds in their game against Latvia, and that Finland scored after 48 seconds in their game against Germany. So Czech Republic have done a sensible thing, just holding on to the ball, not getting themselves into too much trouble. Here's a good opportunity early on, just put wide by Jonas Pulsa, and suddenly the game bursts into life.
Yes. Sometimes the first goal helps to lose the stress, and it doesn't matter actually if you are the one who scored or you are the one who let it in.
Might be putting that to the test in the moment, because suddenly attacking is starting to happen. Patrick Suhanek, 28-year-old, has the ball, plays for Helsingborg, very well-known floorballing outfit. Andre Niemacek, who recently signed for Linköping. And there is Niemacek. He's a player you've been really impressed by so far.
Yes. Since I have been starting to notice in him, because I'm a defender by myself, I really, really like how he's playing, how he sees the pitch, and how good passes he can give up front. He's my favorite in the Czech team.
Martin Kisugita moves the ball on, and now it's going to be a little bit of pressure here for Krista Savonen. Foul was committed, but advantage being played. This is a decent opportunity. Johansson pulls the ball back. Nico Salo going close. Salo has it, the captain. Back to Johansson. In fact, it's a breakaway here now for the Czech Republic. Nearly with the connection was the number 40, Yuri Karni. And if you're watching floorball for the first time, you've just seen the danger there, how quickly the play can get from one end to the other. As we look back at the shot from Jonas Pulsa. Lowry Stenfors wears number 30. Quite a calm beginning so far.
Yes.
Rannanen. Tatu Rannanen, the veteran 35-year-old, once more. That's a good take from Galliala. Rannanen now having trotted up the other end, well positioned. It will be a Czech Republic ball though. Players departing for the sidelines, that's the nature of the line rotation. And some players there for the Czech Republic, part of that partial fourth line, including the veteran Milan Garchar, who we'll doubtless see later on. Three complete lines for each team, plus a couple of goalkeepers, plus a few additional players to use as necessary. Decent work, Benish. It's come loose. Play will be pulled back though. Lively player, Josef Ripar, so far in this competition. Philip Langer, 16 years old, he settled so well. Benesh, a chance goes behind the goal. Couple of options, Langer and Ripar are the two of them. But it's gone away from the Czech Republic. Zana, do you think both coaches will be happy right now? Happy with the start?
Could be actually. None of the teams have had the dangers by the goals for the other team, so yeah.
Content, maybe not happy, but content.
Yes.
Quietly satisfied.
Yes.
They're not ahead, but they're not down.
You can really see that both teams are prepared. They are really careful, they are concentrated. It looks good.
You can bet that both of these teams will have had in mind, since the draw was made, that this game might happen, and they've been preparing for this eventuality. Krista Savonen to Jana Laminen. It's methodical stuff so far, but Finland are good at increasing the pace when they need to. Johansson getting caught up around Niemacek, who's trying to stay strong, and he has stayed strong here, Niemacek, but can he keep hold of it? Tries to use the backboards for assistance. A couple doubling up, Johansson and Salin, and over two of them go. And that will be advantage to Finland. Just couldn't get himself out of trouble there.
And now we can hear that the audience is pretty upset by this whistle, but we could see this little small holding actually from the Czech defender, so it was a totally correct whistle. And these things you cannot see from a distance.
All defenders are good at disguising those, aren't they?
Yeah.
Good opportunity, blocked up over the top. Tom Ondrushek pressing for the host nation. That's with the goalkeeper, Eero Kossonen, hugely experienced. Great opportunity suddenly to break free. And space for Lauri Kalpanen. Kalpanen's shot is smothered by Socek, but Kalpanen suddenly found space there.
Yes. That's a very important part of being a good forward, to be in the right spot.
And this was not in the right spot for the Finns. They played it right towards the Czech Republic, and Adam DeLong put the ball over. It's a little bit of a nervous start for both teams.
Yes.
Maybe just enough work from the covering defender, but DeLong might have fancied himself to score that.
Maybe stress for both of the teams, for Finland losing so easy and for Czechs actually not to score in such a good opportunity.
But this is a good spell now for the Czech Republic. Although they have not yet put the ball into the net, they're starting to threaten. Benesh, Ripar, twisting, turning, and crucially winning, it's come back. But that was great play to get away from Mikko Laikkanen.
It starts to get interesting.
It's warming up, isn't it, here
yes,
in the O2 Arena?
Definitely.
Good play this from Ripar. Goalkeeper perfectly positioned, though.
Very well.
Exactly where you want Kossonen to be. And indeed, Socek at the other end. A good shot from Kapanen, but no danger. That was always the goalkeeper's ball. It's lost. Salin hits up and over. Just a few quiet words here and there from Petri Kettonen to the players. They better not be too quiet, they won't be able to hear over the noise of this crowd. Johansson, goalkeeper reaches out, goes wide. I think he had that one covered anyway, so check. Kisugita under the attentions of Johansson. It's a good ball in the direction of Carney, tough to control though, and away come. Well, I'd say away come Finland. They've got it back, the Czech Republic. Team in red enjoying a decent little spell of possession with Kisugita. But nobody really able to find that decisive pass.
No, not so far. And none of the teams have, like, controlled the ball for a very long time. It's, like, from one to another all the time.
Do you think it's nerves?
Oh, I think so.
The Czech Republic had a bit of a tough awakening in this World Championships when Latvia defeated them 4-3 in a super performance by the Latvian side. And then the Czech Republic were rather bailed out by Germany beating Latvia. DeLong, Ondřej Šek shoots, blocked and away. And then following that, the Czech Republic had a super win over Switzerland. And so actually, it may well be that that defeat to Latvia did the Czech Republic some good. It might have helped them just light the fire.
It feels like that, because the next match they were already like a different team.
They've been a different team since then. Doja, it's blocked. Still Patrick Doja scored a lovely goal against the Danes. Really powerful effort. We will pretty soon have the first little break in play as the lines rotate. Kotilainen darts forward. Lekkonen. Kuzer. Hefty, hefty challenging though from Ripar, but it's left a gap, it's left some space. Lastikar, and put into the back of the net by Jonas Pulsar, and it's the first goal of this semi-final. It's the Czech Republic 0, Finland 1, the reigning world champions strike first. Jonas Pulsar's fourth goal of the World Championships.
Everyone, it looks like that the all five Czech players were actually concentrating for this number 36. They thought that he will shoot by himself, but no. And then they forgot that there is still someone behind. Everyone almost goes for him. And he's totally free there. Very nicely played by Finns.
Lukas Weltschmidt just tracking across, and everyone, as you say, coming into the centre, except him. He stayed out wide, and he was in exactly the right place. Czech Republic 0, Finland 1. They badly need the goal now, the Czech Republic. It's a little bit like some of the air has just come out of a balloon.
Assisted by player number 36, Vila Lastika.
The home fans just sitting there much more quietly now. There's gentle applause. But there needs to be a big response from the host nation. Jana Laminen. Salo. If the contest is level at full time after the three regulation 20 minute periods have been played, we'll have a further 10 minutes of golden score, and then if necessary a penalty competition. And we have the first power break. And it's a power break that sees the Czech Republic trail to Finland by a goal to nil.
Tak schválně, co nám DJ Aleš Matoušek nadiktuje za slov. A je to česká klasika, tak pojďme podpořit naše kluby.
They've had their chances, the Czech Republic. They've had some opportunities, but Finland have kept them pretty effectively at bay and converted their key chance. Czech Republic 0, Finland 1. So many young fans here, thoroughly enjoying the atmosphere of a World Championship semi-final. Possession is with the number 66, Patrick Doja. 33, Martin Prajan. Ondrashevsky is battling in the corner. Aliala brings it forward, a little bit of space emerging. Vananen. Stenfors, the furthest player back. And he will receive it here because Czech Republic just pressing there to try to recover. Do the Czech Republic need to change anything or do they carry on doing what they're doing?
I think they are doing pretty well so far. They had their chances. Okay, they have let in one goal, but it's still only one goal. So I think they are doing fine. They are not backing up very much. Still pretty high. Not letting Finn start the attack so easily.
It's tempting, isn't it, to change everything, to rip apart the playbook and the plans as soon as you go a goal down. They have done here in the Czech Republic is prevent Finland from adding to it for the time being.
But it is Finland also more controlling the ball right now after they got the first goal.
Kotilainen has it. Just on one occasion the Czech Republic have made it to a World Championship final in 2004. So very, very difficult to make that breakthrough into being one of the top two nations. They lost 6-4 to Sweden in that game. 4 years later, the competition was held in Prague. They were defeated 5-4 by Switzerland in the bronze medal game then. Having been defeated here by Finland in the semi-final. So various memories associated with this place. That's a little bit lax. The goal scorer, Jonas Pulso, almost gave the ball away. Crowd have come to life again.
Good for them, good for the match.
Jemacek. That's a nice diagonal ball. Tries to open up the space. Carney is just really trying to hack at it in the air and a little bit...
A little bit too high.
Yes. One can't really have the stick at shoulder height and take a swing.
No, not in floorball.
Salin scored that heartbreak with a goal against the Czech Republic in 2016 as Soček is tested once more. And just a reminder to those of you watching for the first time, it's 3 20-minute periods, so we've got a lot of games still to play out here. This is by no means done and dusted. Salo's shot. Again, a pretty comfortable one for Soček. He'd expect to make that save.
He saw directly when the shot came, so then I think it's pretty easy for the goalkeepers, especially when it's from distance.
And it is a problem in floorball, isn't it? Is not having a direct visual path to the ball.
Yes.
Better from the Czech Republic. Not necessarily the right call from Ondrušek there, but he was well positioned. Stenfors has a look around. Barnanen with a quick sweep in to free Kapanen. Push the ball forward, the Czech Republic, but there are no bodies up there to attack it. And we have 3 minutes until the conclusion of this first period. Mikko Leikkanen. Juha Kivileto. Kivileto able to smile at this stage of the game. He probably wouldn't smile about that if the scoreboard was reversed and it was 17-41 in the third period.
No.
But you can always smile when you're winning. Lucas Feldschmidt moves the ball to Langer. Quickly getting it up here, the Czech Republic. Feldschmidt, shot was charged down by Kotelainen and he threw his body in the way of that.
That was amazing blocking.
Kotelainen picks it up. His reward might be to have a shot, and it's well saved by Soček. Well, that was all created by Petr Kotelainen.
Yes. Everything starts from the defense.
So defenders always say. Goalkeepers will say it all starts from them.
Oh, could be.
Czebek just trying here in this last minute and 15 to get that equalising goal. Again, the goalkeeper Kosonen was exactly in the right place. Tried to sneak the ball for a second time in the gap. There was no gap. Captain Niko Salo to Jana Laminen. Finland are quite happy just to knock this around now.
Yeah, it's a good feeling to end the period with being in the lead.
We see teams do this a lot. They'll wait until there's about 15 seconds or so left and then have one go for an attack, so there's no opportunity for a counter-attack. Might just loft it long, we'll wait and see, or they might just happily keep it here.
I think they will try to do something in the last 10 seconds. Well, we will see.
They've got 2 seconds left to do that. Doesn't look like it. Looks as though Finland are happy just to sit this one out. The fans are not too happy about it. Here they go. And there was just one last opportunity. That is not going to count. They waited just a little too long there.
Yes. We guessed 15, 10, but it was 5. And then they tried something.
But they do have the advantage, the reigning world champions, at the break, at the conclusion of this first period. Lukáš Soček, the only goalkeeper beaten so far, but he has made some very good saves. Adam DeLong had a very decent chance, but couldn't get a clean path through to goal. And at the end of the first period, it's Czech Republic 0, Finland 1. Just a brief look at the statistics of the first period, but we're at that stage of the competition where what really matters is the statistic at the very bottom, which is the lone goal scored by Finland, scored by Jonas Pulsa, with the assist coming from the number 36, Villa Lastica. They won't be too concerned about trailing 1-0 at the end of the first period. There's plenty of time to play. We know that both of these nations can be big scorers. And so we begin the second period. Finland take possession early on. And the team in the white and blue attacking the goal to your right here as we start the second of three 20-minute periods. Zana Klavere joins me. And Zane, what do you imagine the coaches might have said in that 15-minute break?
Hard to say, actually, because I think that both teams have started quite okay. There were no big mistakes or really like someone was pushed down really hard and they really would need to shape it up for. It has been, I think, a good first period.
Thomas Anderson laying down the law. Decent hit, actually, that was blocked by the feet of Jana Laminen. Tatu Vananen moving the ball to Lauri Stenfors. Lauri Kapanen comes forward, opened his body up nicely for the shot, just a little too much on the angle. Czech Republic to try to clear defensively. Oh, it's nicely played right down in the direction of DeLong. I think that caught the Finnish defence out, but they recovered smartly. Stenfors goes behind the goal, and Finland good at bringing this ball away. 22 is Jani Kukkola. It's such a well-known fixture in the world of floorball, the Czech Republic versus Finland. Finland have won 35 times against the Czech Republic. There have been three draws and only three victories for the Czech team. That's not a statistic that makes for very comfortable listening for the host nation, but it's always a bit different, isn't it, when it's in this kind of place?
Yes, and I think also that the preparation might be totally different also with this new coach that they have welcomed into the team, and they knew that they are the home team, and the hopes and everything was so much higher than the previous championships. So I think it is a little bit different preparation for the last 2 years than they ever had, I might even say.
A few times we've seen the Czech Republic just trying to work the ball around sharply from behind the goal and try to catch out Eero Kosonen at his near post. It's interesting to see whether that's a plan they'll continue with. They haven't had any joy with it so far. It's blocked and Veldschmidt comes in just to help out Lukas Soček.
It's very important for the defender to take the rebound, otherwise you can really make your goalkeeper upset.
Jemacek. Still Jemacek. Jendrzejczak turns and hits. Jemacek's got a little bit of space, struggling to control, but turns tidily into the corner. And here is Lauri Kapanen. Line rotations, bringing on the likes of Tatu Vananen. Well, it feels actually very similar to the start of the first period.
Yes. Still continue pretty safe, I would even say.
Oh, that was so nearly played into the path of Ondra Czech. Couple of inches away from a perfect connection on that as Yuri Bauer moves it to Ondra Czech once more. He's under pressure here, Ondra Czech, and he's won the free hit. Oh, it's going to be put in, is it? No.
Oh, they were a little bit too close. They stepped into the goalkeeper's pitch.
Anxious times, though. Very anxious times, yes, for the Czech Republic. Let's have another look.
And here, he like came out of nowhere.
Comes clattering down off the bar,
Czech,
yes.
Czech defense.
Socek was a busy, busy goalkeeper there.
Yes. I think number 64 was even surprised that there was still someone behind me.
That's a great run all the way through from Kiviletto. Broke through with worrying ease and nearly poked it home. It's been blocked. Great work from the number 8, Kiviletto. Just took matters into his own hands, did Juha Kiviletto. And this is how. And this the pullback. Lottilainen to Kiviletto, who was still in the right position.
He got a very good pass from behind the goal, but he was in the position there was not that easy to score, surrounded by a lot of Czech players.
But it does feel like a bit of a 55-45 sort of game, doesn't it?
Yes, a slightly more control from Finnish team, but I would not say that they are like really running over Czechs right now.
This could get them closer. Johansson getting really tangled up.
It starts to get a little bit physical, match.
Certainly does, and it was a good opportunity. Well, Sami Johansson, he scored 2 goals against the Czech Republic in the 2016 semi-final. And he actually scored a really important goal that gave the Finns a 3-1 advantage. He was unable to ensure a 2-goal lead here. Patrick Doja. Little clumsy in possession, but he's recovered well. Shows some composure, the Floorball Konitz player. Ondra Czech, nicely dealt with by Kosselman, but the right idea, test the keeper.
Yes.
Kero Kosselman has actually looked very, very good so far in the Finnish goal.
Yes, very convincing in his game. But actually, the Czech goalkeeper too. I think both goalkeepers are really good so far.
Patrick Suhanek. Geldschmidt in possession. Langer, still Langer. I think the goalkeeper blocked that one. Good clean opportunity for Philip Langer. Lekkonen happy just to play this in the direction of Kotilainen. What a bit of pace from Kotilainen to move away, to pass it into Lastica, and stopped at the other end by Socek. But all of that from Kotilainen.
Yes.
We look back first at the chance from Langer. Pulser maybe just did enough to help steer that ball in the direction of the keeper at the other end. Very nearly
so
Kotilainen.
So close. And he started up everything by himself. Very nice attack.
Villelastica, the pace has just increased suddenly in the last minute or so. We've gone from second into third gear, I would say. There is the danger, if you didn't know it before, of Petter Kotilainen. He can suddenly look as though he's starting a 100 metres race. He'll just burst away. Kendra Schack. Carney trying to be physically strong.
He won that situation.
But ultimately it does fall to Krista Savonen. Good chance, put wide, Carney picks up. Jendra Schack not able to convert. Both teams going close. This is a really interesting spell. Finnish fans looking like they're enjoying themselves. And why not? Because they are a goal up in a World Championship semi-final. But the home fans still have belief here in the O2 Arena in Prague. Czech Republic have never defeated Finland in a World Championship semi-final. And Finland are a funny team to try and assess in a World Championship, because you often feel like you can't really assess Finland until it gets to the semi-final stage, because they keep a lot in reserve.
Yes, they do. They do.
Noja.
Maybe that's some kind of tactical game that they actually don't want to show exactly what they are capable for until it's the time, like it's the semi-finals.
There have been plenty of times as the power break and the halfway point of the game arrives, plenty of times where people have gone, oh, Finland aren't looking that great this year, and then Finland get to the semi-finals and suddenly start playing
sensationally. And suddenly they're amazing, yes.
Super run from Kivileto all the way through Kotilainen, then setting up Kivileto to nearly score. Johansson shaping and producing a shot, good technique from the number 77. This the hit from Ondra Schack, and then Philip Langer.
3, 2, 1, 3!
And Kotilainen, a brilliant save from Soček, right under the legs. Czech Republic 0, Finland 1. It's firmly balanced, it's on a knife edge. We're into the second half of the game. The only goal scored by Jonas Pulsa in the first period.
That's an actually very surprising result. One goal so far.
Bauer, one of the two Bauers, the other Lukáš, the backup goalkeeper for the Czech Republic, and there 33 Martin Prožan. They know the Finnish fans, it's far too early to be celebrating.
Way too early.
They're enjoying themselves, but not too much at the moment. Calm presence to have in your team, Kivileto. He turns 37 on Boxing Day. One of the many Finnish players in the national team who plays for Classic in Tampere. Excellent team with a very fine reputation. Not too happy about that one, Petter Kotilainen. We're now at the stage of the game where decisions that don't go your way aren't fun anymore.
No, not like we saw in the first period. Now it starts to get real.
Next goal, should there be one, is going to be absolutely massive. And that was a decent hit. Giviletto plays it back in the direction of Lastica. Not sure Lastica knew he was getting it, but he's recovered nicely, the number 36. Giviletto, challenge here from Weltschmidt. He's got to watch out. Yeah, a little too physical. Had the arms all over the back of Giviletto, really. Climbing all over him. Oh, that is a wonderful hit from Mikko Lekkonen, and there is the massive second goal, and it's a Finnish goal. Mikko Lekkonen's first World Championship goal. That's a pretty useful time to produce your first one.
Yes, and what an excellent shot he had.
It's a marvellous moment for Lekkonen, and he's had a horrible time of it with injuries. His career has been blighted by injury problem after injury problem, but he's fought back, he's persevered, he's made it to the national team, and he's just scored in a World Championship semi-final. How happy they are that he kept going. The 30-year-old Mikko Lekkonen scores his first ever World Championship goal. It's Czech Republic 0, Finland 2. Well, it's not at all the kind of inspirational moment the host nation wanted, but for you as a fan of the sport of floorball, Dana, and as a player of the sport of floorball, you'll know what an inspirational moment that is for a player who's battled with such bad injury.
Yes, yes, yes. It's super good for him to come back and be in a team and then to do this kind of goal in such a crucial match.
He took it well too, took it with authority, Šebek. So the question is, now what? For Petri Kettonen's team, a couple of goals would be a decent start.
I think so.
It took a while from first to second goal, over 20 minutes.
I think it's important not to let them too far away if you want to have a chance still to save this match in the third period.
They can come back from two goals. It can be done. It's getting tougher and tougher though now. Deflected away, Suhanek involved in that. They haven't had a great deal to cheer about. They've stayed in very good spirits, the Czech fans, for the whole game, but we're now at the stage where time is just a little concerning for the host nation. And Finland are looking dangerous as they come forward and break. Pulsa not able to get the ball from Kotilainen, who shoots straight into Socek's body. Martin Prajan has possession. They've only had four shots on goal, the Czech Republic. Just have to find some way through here, Ondrušek. Can't do it. It's been a big display from Kosinen in goal. It's easy to ignore the goalkeeper at a time like this when one team's 2-0 up, but actually he's played really well.
Yes, the work he has done brilliantly so far.
Salo moves it back Savonen. Johansson sends it on into the corner, will likely get it back, will get it back, good stop from Soček. Čebek really muscled physically off the ball by Salo and Salin. Home fans are not at all happy about that, referees say, it's all fair.
It was not like someone pushed someone from behind. They were like running next to each other fighting for the ball, and then it's totally different. Someone wins, someone loses, but it was not against the rules.
Experienced officials, Thomas Anderson and Rickard Wissman. And some players there on the Finnish bench who are experienced in breaking Czech hearts at the semi-final stage of a World Championships. If you're just joining us, it is the fifth meeting in the semi-finals between the Czech Republic and Finland. And it's four wins so far for Finland. We're on course for a fifth Finnish win here. They're decidedly more relaxed than they were 5 minutes ago. Jani Kukkola wins the decision. Kirileto hits that one out of play. And he's really trying to get them motivated on the sidelines now, Kettonen. Trying to get them to believe this one is within their grasp. It's just a goal, isn't it? One suddenly changes the whole mood of the O2 Arena.
It would mean super much if they would be able to score now and then to end this period actually with not being under two.
Juha Kivileto. He knows how to see out a semi-final, Kivileto. He's been part of all of their World Championship winning teams. He's so experienced, and he finds Jonas Pulser, and this game is going away from the Czech Republic. They're disappearing without trace here, the host nation. Finland have a third goal, and they've got a big foot now wedged in the door towards the final.
Three goals is a lot to play back against Finland.
Pulser just came all the way forward, hit it with such authority.
Yes, it's like he feels a little, it feels like he's actually being left alone, and the people are thinking, will he pass or what will happen? It looks a little bit that they are actually looking. Everyone is looking at him. No one is actually trying to do that much.
Just a circle of red shirts around Jonas Pulser as he hit that ball, and then a whole load of red shirts looking around at each other saying,
who was the one who needed to take this player? Is probably what they are thinking now.
It really does look as though the Czech players have been overawed by this occasion. They've become passengers now in this game. They haven't been able to break the Finnish resolve, the Finnish experience. It's just a very disappointed look on the face of Matej Jędrysiak. Again, Zanuk, just one goal here, keeps it alive heading into the third. But it was such a matter-of-fact run and finish. This is a good chance, it's a good block again. Gita firing at Kosson, and that's been the difference. The Czech Republic have put it at the body of the goalkeeper quite a lot. Finland have found those gaps. Up and over the top, Benes.
now they have some chances at least, so that's good for the match. This was a very good opportunity.
Been a lively little spell this for the Czech Republic. Langer inside the last couple of minutes of the second period.
It's like they have decided three goals is too much. Now we need to start to do something by ourselves.
The problem is, as they come forwards now to attack this three-goal deficit, they will leave themselves vulnerable to a counter-punch. And Finland are pretty good at the counter-punch.
Yes, very good.
In fact, they excel at the counter-punch. Kukula. I'm not sure that many of the Finland players thought they'd be 3-0 up at this stage of the game.
No, I actually didn't think that by myself.
Lauri Stenfors, this is a repeat of the conclusion of the first period. Finland just happy to move the ball around. They'll eat up the time here. Kotilainen.
Should we try to guess now again? How many seconds in before the end?
Well, we're not very good at it, are we?
No.
We always get it wrong.
So we will just look.
We'll stick on 5 seconds and see if we get an attack here. The home crowd absolutely loathe this. They're not happy at all with this possession game being played by the Finns, Kivileto to Pulse. But the Finns won't be at all unhappy about this. Getting the crowd riled up, getting the Czech players riled up, they'll be perfectly content. Kivileto holds on, and that brings to a close the second period. Oh, it's a long way back now for Petri Kettunen's team. This is going to be the third period of their lives if they're to take this back. Finland are masters at getting into World Championship finals. They've done it 9 times. They're very, very close to doing it on a 10th occasion here in the O2 Arena in Prague. The Czech Republic have yet to find their rhythm in this game. At the end of the second period, Czech Republic 0, Finland 3. It's the O2 Arena in Prague that's hosting the World Floorball Championships of 2018, and semi-final time as we move into the third period. I'm trying to find a way, if you're a Czech Republic fan, of presenting this positively for you, but it's Czech Republic 0, Finland 3. The only small crumb of comfort is there's still 20 minutes left for the Czech Republic to turn it around. I don't have to put a positive spin on it if you're a Finnish fan, because it's all going absolutely according to plan for the reigning world champions. They have been calm, they've been determined, and they've managed the occasion. It's about match management, and Finland are very experienced at winning semi-finals. Petr Kotilainen has looked able to do what he always does, which is suddenly find the pace and explode down the sideboards. So the question remains, is there a way back for the host nation? There, the veteran Mika Kohonen, the 41-year-old, the only surviving player in the Finnish squad from the World Games in 1997. His coach actually played, or rather the Czech Republic coach actually played alongside Mika Kohonen in that World Games team. They are on opposite sides at the moment. And it's Finland heading into the final, unless there can be a massive, massive turnaround. Olli Hogben here, joined by Zana Klabere, who's played at the highest level in 5 World Championships for Latvia and has played in a semi-final. What now for the Czech Republic? How on earth do they find a way back into this? Is there a way back into it?
It might be, it might be. I still hope it's not all over yet for the Czechs. I still think that they will be able to show these last 20 minutes that there is still some strength left, and they have a very good coach, so I'm pretty sure there were a lot of talks now how to break up this Finnish defense tactically and actually go and manage to score.
Patrick Suhanek. They're going to have to play big and bold and gamble here, the Czech Republic. If they're going to lose this, they might as well lose it 6-0 rather than not going for this.
Yes, then it doesn't matter anymore.
Lange dispossessed. Finland come forward. They won't rush forward here, Finland, unless it's necessary, unless there's a really clear chance. They'll happily not take any risks at the back. Well, those of you who are students of the sport will know that the track record here, the history books favoured Finland. I'm not quite sure they favoured Finland as much as this score and indeed this performance has suggested. It's turned out to be far more comfortable for Finland than I think many thought it might be. They are now starting to dream of the final and the meeting with Sweden or Switzerland. Will be a Czech Republic ball. They've got to construct something soon. Lukáš Soček beaten on 3 occasions. At the other end, Eero Kosonen has really looked unstoppable, but at the same time, the Czech Republic have not really hit the shots into the corners. There's a lot that's been straight at his body. And they'll be perfectly happy, won't they, Finland, if the Czech Republic are shooting from this kind of distance.
Yes.
That's better, that's much better. Not a bad opportunity, the right place to put the ball. He hasn't had an awful lot, Adam DeLong, since that early opportunity which went over the top. 14 times Finland have blocked shots, the Czech Republic only on 2 occasions, and it's been, Zana, hasn't it, a feature of the game, the Czech Republic maybe not getting close enough to the attacker, not getting close enough to the shot.
Yes, Finns don't let that many options go when there is not that many openings where they actually can do a free shot.
Čebek. It's a good pullback. This is a better spell from the Czech Republic. Jendrišák went close. Goalkeeper gathers. Can he distribute fast? Opts for the simple ball as the players rotate. Josef Ripa, who scored 2 against Germany, 1 against Denmark, They need somebody to step forward here.
Now they had some nice options, but unfortunately, either missed or blocked or...
It's given away Langer, and it's right in the path of Kaliala. That was a great bit of goalkeeping. Crucial touch from Soček.
Will this be the little boost they need now? We hope.
Yes, from a neutral perspective, you want every semi-final to be a competitive game. Josef Rupa. Feldschmidt's thinking about a hit. Rupa. One of the things that Finland are just so good at, Zane, is deciding how fast or slow the game is to be played.
Yes, yes. If they want to slow it down, they just keep it there in their defense zone. They can do it very well.
It's blocked from a long way out, the shot from Drazan. Now the Czech Republic through Niemacek, some rather desperate defending. But they're starting to push forward aggressively now.
Would be so good for the game if this pays back actually with a Czech goal instead of that they lose it somewhere and the Finns contra-attack and score.
It's another good effort, another good save, Ondrušek. They're testing the goalkeeper. Just for their own sense of self-confidence, of self-esteem to get something now. Finally, it seems the Czech Republic have woken up.
I hope it's not too late. I was hoping for that kind of game actually a little bit earlier, but there is still time.
Again, they go close, but again, there is no yield. And Finland actually now are soaking up the Czech pressure well. But is there a way through once more? Eero Kosonen, unbeatable. Goalkeeper has gathered it. And that, well, there's no need for this. There's no need for this.
Very typical defending goalkeeper situation.
Clearer heads will prevail. Clearer heads will prevail. They must remain calm. It's a massive, massive game though. It's hard to remain calm in a space like this, in a place like this, at a time like this.
But this was super good change for the Czech team. They attack almost all the time. And the Finnish team started also to do these little mistakes, so...
Well handled by the officials, Messrs. Anderson and Wissman. They dealt with that pretty calmly. Savonen going in to defend his goalkeeper. He just did it a little on the aggressive side, and then Yuri Kani responding, and it's all got rather tempestuous.
But here, when he's already lying down on the ball, this was the situation that they defended. He went in with the stick a little bit too late there. But there won't be any 2 minutes.
We're just awaiting confirmation. And there, both teams
for
reduced.
Yes.
Yeah, the referee decided it was six of one, half a dozen of another. It's actually Savonen and Kani for that little altercation. Here was the initial shot from Ondrušek. That's an earlier attack.
Indeed. these situations, when one is defending a goalkeeper and the other one tries to skate, score, then you usually either don't give anything or give to both teams.
So both players reduced by one. We have a slightly less compact playing area, and maybe that will favour the Czech Republic as they have to be the aggressors and have to push into that space.
We will see.
Kiviletto. If you're just joining the action, it's the third period. Czech Republic 0, Finland 3. Finland scored after 11 minutes and 16 seconds. Took them a little time, about 20 minutes, to add another. Czech Republic have not yet had any great signs that a recovery is on. They've had a couple of half-decent moments, and now we have a double power play situation, which I suppose means no power play situation, because both nations losing players, Krista Savonen and Juri Kani, for an altercation in front of the goal as Eero Kossonen blocked the ball.
Some nations plays overtime, 4-4. I unfortunately don't know if these two nations does that in their own home championships, so then they could be already very well used to this.
Doja. It's loose again, and once again they go in combatively. It's going to be a Czech Republic ball. Assertive refereeing from Thomas Anderson.
Free hit now.
This is a good opportunity to work the Finnish defence. Now is the time to be calm. Now is the time to remember your training, your set-piece playbook. Can they work it right? Yes, they can! Oh, yes, they can! Matej Jendrišák gets the goal from the set-piece for the Czech Republic. Hang on a minute. Have we got a game on here?
I think so. It actually looked that there is zero option for the goal.
Finally, something to dance about, something to sing about.
All four Finnish players are sitting down so well, and still he finds this.
I've looked at that twice now and I still can't see where the gap was.
Me neither.
But there was one, and Matej Jendrišák, the captain, found it. You need your captain to step up and deliver. What a reaction from Lukas Soucek as well. Šebek to Jendrišák, just right down low through the middle. It's game on. Czech Republic 1, Finland 3. Suddenly the O2 Arena has something to believe in. They have a host nation to cheer for once more. Have the Czech Republic left it too late? The two penalties have come to an end, so both players back on the field of play now, Savonen and Kani. And there is a first touch for Savonen. Got a lot of efforts from Adam DeLong to win back the ball. Emily Salin loses out, Niemacek wins possession. Martin Kitagita. Well, just imagine now, if you think it's loud in here, what will happen if the Czech Republic manage to get one more? Finally, a really decisive bit of shooting from the Czech attack.
Yes.
Beneš, Jendrusák, Beneš, he's still got it. Just a moment's hesitation, that is absolutely a clear foul from Jendrusák, and the referee comes over and says, look, I'm keeping an eye on this, I don't like the way it's going. It's a high-spirited affair here in the O2 Arena in Prague. Jemacek reading the game nicely, stepping in. Czech Republic recover possession. Recovering his balance, Pulsa. And he's gone all the way through, Pulsa. Good stop from Socek. Read that well.
Goalkeeper saved the team again.
Martin Prajan looks for the best option. They're not rushing it at the moment, the Czech Republic. Two goals can come quickly in floorball. Patrick Doja. This is a nice move. It's a good chance. Did it come off the post or was that saved? Either way, it's not in. Narrow, narrow margins. Czech Republic are lively. Lekkonen, along with Kivileto, the two Finnish players who are rather hemmed in. Kivileto using his strength. Finland just a hit and hope, and it's worked well to Villelastica. This is the Czech Republic that everyone wanted to see.
Yes, it really is.
Whatever Petri Kettinen said after the second period, it worked. It's probably not repeatable, but it worked.
Definitely.
Nikolaj Krubets is on, the number 89, the 19-year-old. Wonder if he can step forward and play sometimes with the freedom that youth brings. Without memories of big defeats to the Finns. His World Championship debut. But Finland handling things the right way now, just keeping possession and not trying to overcommit.
Yes.
And that means that Grabetz is going to have to go in here to try and force them. Three players back.
Finland is good at this.
The crowd don't like it, but it's effective. It's how you match manage your way into a World Championship final. Just trying to quieten down the Czech Republic. Suddenly they turn on the pace. Salin. Too much of a stretch, and it's once more Finland, it's once more Salins. And all of this ball movement from Finland is forcing the Czech players to really run around. Unsurprisingly, the lines change here. Jani Kukula.
Yes, it's tiring. It's more tiring play without the ball.
Vanhanen. This is good play, this is really good play. Goalkeeper perhaps does enough to put off Lauri Kalpanen, but Kalpanen puts it to Kailiala. He scored in the semi-final 2 years ago, and that might just be the heartbreaker.
It could be, unfortunately.
I think he knows it as well. It was such a crucial goal to get when the Czech Republic were enjoying their best spell.
Three goals under again. Seven.
It just seemed to evade Kisugita as it came across the box.
Will we go back to the assist talk again? This was super good pass. He did all the hard work here, number 18. brilliant.
He won't score many goals more important than he won't score many goals easier than that. Niko Kailiala. He scored the second and final goal in the World Games bronze medal match against the Czech Republic. He might have had the final say here. Czech Republic 1, Finland 4, back to a three-goal game. And with precious little time. Got a line earned, they put it away now, it's done. Villalastica, Finland fantastica. They are surely heading into a World Championship final, their 10th.
Everything started with a losing ball up there, by the middle. And then they just played it very nicely.
And it's that burst of pace once more from Kotilainen, and he took it really well. The 22-year-old Steelers player, Villalastica, with a steely eye in front of goal, slams it home.
Such a small mistake there by the middle line, but it sometimes ends up in situations like these against very skillful opponents.
Czech Republic 1, Finland 5. What a response from the reigning world champions this has been. When the pressure was on, when the Czech Republic got that goal, Finland transformed.
They stopped it very quickly.
It's not been at all the kind of game he hoped it would be as we go into the final power break. Fanzónách napříč Českou republikou Floorballová republika je propojená fanouci fandí ve 12 městech. Well, the romantics in the sport of floorball were desperately hoping for the Czech Republic to deliver in their home world championships. But Finland were not into romance, Finland were into winning.
No. They wanted to be sure that this is our match.
That the only moment of glory so far for the Czech Republic. Close range finish from Kailiala. And then shortly after this, Kotilainen providing the ball for Villalastica. Czech Republic 1, Finland 5. And credit here to Eero Kossonen. 93% of shots saved. Not the same sort of success for poor old Lukasz Soucek, who's had a very, very busy time of things. Pretty soon, the Czech Republic will have to turn their attentions to the bronze medal game, where they will meet either Sweden or Switzerland. And indeed, Finland will meet either Sweden or Switzerland, because that game is coming up after this, and we will bring you live English commentary for that game on a variety of platforms. Wherever in the world you are watching this from, it's a pleasure to have your company as the World Championships of Floorball in men's competition in 2018 reaches its penultimate day. It is so hard to come into your home championships. There's sometimes a feeling that maybe because you've got the crowd alongside you, because you've got the passion of being the home nation, that it will somehow magically help you find a way past the very best teams. But there's a reason why Finland have won 3 out of the last 5 World Championships.
Yes, yes. The result, though, is a little bit surprising. I never thought it will be 1-5 for Finland.
Timeout called by the Czech Republic. They'll have to go empty net at some point soon just to try and get what they can.
and for four goals to gain back, it could be pretty early, actually.
If you're watching your first floorball match, then the goalkeeper can be withdrawn and an extra outfielder put on. What that means is the goalkeeper stands on the sidelines, gets ready to sub in and out, and that's exactly what's happened now.
It's already now.
Well, it's the right move, really, because they've got to go for it, haven't they? They've got to overload.
Like you said earlier, now it doesn't count if it's 5, 6, 7. They need to start to gain some goals back.
What is sometimes called the artificial power play here. The self-engineered power play with the goalkeeper withdrawn. And he's ready, Lukasz Nowczyk. He might have to dash on very, very fast indeed. This is a chance. Benes just didn't seem to play that wholeheartedly. That's better. Whistle has gone. And it's gone against the Czech Republic. Jendrišák in some discomfort. Have to see exactly what happened here. Now it looks as though it's going the other way. The Finnish team already lining up and defending the goal.
Here. That was a hard squeeze between two Finnish players.
Well, the dinner menu is Jendrišák sandwich. And Czech Republic hungry for a goal but not able to finish. Got to watch out here. Goalkeeper back in. Now he goes again. It's going to be sprinting time for Soček. It's going to be heart-stopping time at the end of this game. It's a long way back though now. It's a really long way back, but you never know. You just never know in this wild and sometimes absolutely heart-stopping sport. Enes, again, not the truest of connections.
Blocked again. And now it's 2 minutes.
Well, this is interesting. And the tempers are fraying once more. Salo just comes over and says, everyone go away, I'll chat to the referee. That's what you want your captain to do, is have a calm conversation. Emily Salin.
Now the question is, will they go 5-4 or they will actually continue 6-4?
What would you do?
6-4 might be more efficient.
It feels like now is not the time to hedge your bets. Now is the time just to go for it.
Yes.
So the Czech Republic have a power play advantage. They've been playing with an empty net. Looks as though they're going to carry on that way. Actually, Lukasz Nowczyk is coming back into the goal. So for the time being, it's just going to be 5-on-4. That's because Finland have possession. When they recover, Nowczyk's now going to go. Here we go. Okay. So it's 6-on-4. A lot of space now for the Czech Republic, but not much space in terms of the timer, which is at 16 and almost a half. Maybe didn't need to hit it from there. They've got it back almost, Ripart. Doja's got loads of space. Pulled back across, trying to control it. Just not quite running at the moment. Doja, he might well hit this. Ripart is in a tangle. Now he's got the ball back. 18 times the Finns have blocked a shot of the Czech Republic. Patrick Doja, they pulled it back, they pulled one back, we're back to a three-goal game. Daniel Szebek. It's still a very long way back for the Czech Republic, but that will give them some hope. Three goals, 3 minutes. Can it be done? Don't know, but it's going to be fun finding out.
It is possible, it is possible. And this was so nice played.
they really use that they are plus two players. Find this free opening in the middle. Nicely played.
For the second time, they score keeping that ball really low.
Yes.
Daniel Shebek, the player for Helsingborg, playing a key role in getting the Czech Republic back in the game. Once more, Lukas Soucek goes to the sidelines. Jemacek. Now he gives way. Doja, who played a key role in the build-up to that goal.
And now Finland decide to go so high up. You see how hard it is for Czechs to even start it up. This 6-5
just eats up some time.
Yes,
and it means if Finland do steal the ball, they've got an empty net to put it into very quickly. They have an empty net to put it into very quickly, and they've done it. Villa Lastica, that is the one that ends this. It has to be finally the one that ends this. Well, you spotted it, Zanet. Finland playing that high line, attacking the defence of the Czech Republic as they couldn't build anything. Clever move that, and it worked. Beneš just caught, he was the assister for the Czech Republic's second goal. He was unintentionally the assister for the finish goal here. And a composed finish for Lastica.
Unfortunate to give a pass like this. But it happens.
Czech Republic 2, Finland 6. It's been agonizing for the Czech Republic. Every time they've nearly got back in contention, Finland have torn it away from them. But if it does finish in this way, it's a fair result, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
Finland have been the better team from start to finish, there's no doubt about it. Even the most ardent of Czech Republic fans would be hard-pressed to argue that they haven't been pretty well dominated by the team in white and blue. But goodness me, they have entertained this Czech Republic team. Finland doing what they do effectively, hold on to possession. Lauri Stenfors particularly good at that. Statu Vanhanen likewise. Czech Republic running out of time to muscle the ball off the Finnish defence, and they've done it. Play has been pulled back. It will be a Czech Republic ball. Too much of a stretch, there's an empty net here. It's unguarded, it's another. Sami Johansson, and there's no doubt anymore. Finland heading into their 10th World Championship final, the reigning world champions. And they're cruising now. Salin winning the ball. Once again, Czech Republic dispossessed with no goalkeeper.
Some small mistakes there and there. And
well, he got two goals 2 years ago. History repeating itself. Sami Johansson, goal scorer again, and Finland once again are heading into a World Championship final at the expense of the Czech Republic, the fifth time this has happened.
Assisted by their number 9, Emil Salin.
Credit to the Czech Republic, they're still going for this, they're still attacking, but now it will be the bronze medal game for the host nation.
Most likely.
And actually it's going to be a tough one for them now to pick themselves back up for, because this one just hasn't gone their way at all. Finland have masterminded a very professional display. And lest we be overly critical of the Czech Republic, let us remember, this is the world number one nation. These are the reigning world champions. These are some of the very finest players on earth. And they were in no mood to be sentimental in this game. Nor should they have been. They've taken their chances. Young players like Ondrej Němeček, he'll get other opportunities down the line.
He will.
He'll get better. He will develop, he will learn, he'll come back stronger. Adam DeLong, likewise. There's great hope for the Czech Republic. There's great hope for these young players. But it's Finland who head into the World Championship final. A comprehensive victory over the host nation. The better team. And maybe another title heading their way. We'll know soon who their opponents will be. We know the Czech Republic are heading into the bronze medal game. Petri Kettinen's team defeated by Petri Nurki's side. Much for them to replay in their minds now, the Czech Republic. But they came up against the Finland team in fine form.
But it's still something to fight for tomorrow.
What a display by Eero Kossonen in the Finnish goal, but what a display by his defenders as well, who blocked shot after shot after shot. At the end of the first semi-final, it's Czech Republic 2, Finland 7. The reigning world champions are going into the final. Josef Rypar, given a warm round of applause by the crowd here in the O2 Arena for his efforts. Not able to find the target and add to his goals against Germany and Denmark. But he's made a really effective World Championship debut at the age of 25. Gaining experience on the international scene and will likely be an important player in that bronze medal contest. The best player of the tournament. The player number 66, Mikko Leikkanen. What a moment this is for Mikko Leikkanen. His World Championship debut at the age of 30. Year after year after year of horrific injuries, but he never gave up, he never stopped. And guess what? He's going to play in a World Championship final. How's that for heart? They will be back tomorrow. I'm sure you will be too, but don't go too far away because we have the second semi-final coming up soon. The contest between Sweden and Switzerland to follow. And we will know in a few hours' time the lineup for the World Championship final that takes place tomorrow here in the O2 Arena. But we'll leave you with the story of today. And there's so often the story. They are the reigning world champions, they are Finland, and they're heading into the final.
Nechat a obhájit doma medaily. A této hře stále jsme, protože zítra se utkáme v bitvě o bronz. My toho budeme a vy toho dosáhnete taky. Protože tento bronz si zaslouží naši podporu. I zítra v bitvě o bronz. Poslední kvalifikovaný český tým zaslouží poklad za tento hry. Vidíte, že jste tu s námi byli, že jste
součástí, co se vyčeká. Ještě jednou, Vítěz.